Thank you for joining us for the latest episode of One Play Classic. And we've seen tremendous action in our coverage of grassroots, school, national and international sport, and we applaud the athletes for their commitment. Now, this featured match is a perfect example of the entertainment on offer, so let's not waste any more time and get straight into the action.
It is a battle for second place. Remember, that position is currently occupied by Hougang. They're in a relatively good run of form. Tampines Rovers in fourth place, but they do have a game in hand. Let's have a look at the team sheets. And we start with the home side, Tampines Rovers. And they make three changes to the side that drew with Warriors in that shock result last week, with Akmal Azman, Khairul Amri, and Zeruddin Mehmedovic on the bench. In come Irwan Shah, Shah Shahiran, and Jordan Webb. Now for Hougang, they just make the one change from the side that lost in agonizing manner against DPMM. That was in added time when they lost against DPMM. And the only change is a goalkeeping one, with Karolin Khalid on the bench. Ridwan Baruddin comes back into the side. Kade Yaya there, of course, a man needs little introduction for football lovers in Singapore. He's, of course, a big, big name. The officials, by the way, G. Lechman, assisted by Mohamed Shakawi, and Lim Si Seng, the fourth official. Sorry, excuse me. The referee, Ahmad Akasha, his assistants, Manoj Kalwani, Khairuddin Khalid, and the fourth official, Abirami Naidu. Both teams full of talent, full of Singapore internationals. A lot going for them. We're expecting, hopefully, I don't want to jinx anything, but a top-notch match here. So it will be Tampines to get us going. Hougang, as usual, with the two big men at the back, Afiq Yunus and Kong Ho Won, Dan Bennett and Amrul Adli at the back for Tampines Rovers. Here is Jordan Webb, who was rather anonymous, I have to say, in that game against Yangon United. Here's Irwan Shah, who likes to drift infield. He's, of course, the left back in this game, but he does cut in or drift in quite a bit. Gets set to Amrul Adli. Now, Shadan Sulaiman just saw the two runs there of both Shah Shahiran and Rotaro Mugumi. But it's cut out there by Jordan Vestering. Now Shadan. Interesting to see no Khairul Amri. Of course, a veteran these days, he might play a little sparingly. Madu Mahana goes up to Rotaro Mugumi. Again, well handled by Vestering. Zulfami Arifin will just shepherd that out. Well, Well, you do expect as a home side for Tampines to be putting all the pressure on. That ball up towards Stipe Plazibat. They normally play something like a 4-3-3. And it's interesting to see that it is not Plazibat who is the target man. He's not the centre forward, as it were. The centre forward is Amar Zalani. Hasn't quite managed to keep that in. Faris Ramli up against Dan Bennett, former international teammates. Here is Madu. Leading the line today, it is Yasser Hanapi. They look to be playing almost like a 4-3-3 themselves. The three consisting of Jordan Webb, Yasser Hanapi and Ritara Megumi. So both sides almost playing something like a false nine, particularly Tampines Rovers today. Though there are, of course, Plazibat is an out-and-out striker. There's Anumantan. Now, going forward, Zalani, Amar Zalani. Oh, he's got it caught under his feet. And that's very good work by Joel Chu. Both teams just feeling each other out at the moment. Shahiran getting involved. Jordan Webb won't get there. He looked a bit frustrated with that ball. Ridwan. Now Stipe Plazibat. Will he get the cross in? It will be a corner. Works hard, doesn't he, Stipe Plazibat, back in Singapore football after a year away. Has been in the goals for both Hougang in the past and most notably with Home United. Now Joel Chu. Here's Webb. He'll embark on a little run there. Foul. My Plazibat. It's all pretty friendly at the moment. Shadan. Joel Chu seeing a lot of the ball in these early stages. Good to see for the youngster. Nineteen-year-old Joel Chu. A little bit too much on their ball. pretty sedate start to this game, in which we are looking at contesting that second spot in the SPL. First time I think he's really had to touch the ball. Tampines goalkeeper, Shazwan Buhari. A few challenges going in, but it's all very amicable at the moment. Now Jordan Webb. Ball over the top. I think it was an offside flag there on Jordan Webb. Manos Kowani running the line on this end. Early stages, but it is lacking in intensity at the moment, given what is at stake. Nice ball out, Jordan Vestering. He's up against Madu Mahana. Did well there. Faris has just gone onto that right-hand side for a while. He's swapped with Stipe Plazibat. Kong Ho Won just going a little further forward, looking to cross that in for Plazibat. Amir Ladli. Almost lost possession there. Anu's done well. Now Faris Ramli gets a cross in early, and I'm not sure what Amir Zalani was trying to do there. Rather comical. Well, I think he was trying to do some kind of scissors kick. It was an odd attempt, really, from the Hougang forward. I'm sure he'll say that would have been looked spectacular had he done it. Here's Zulfami Arafin, who will just drop back with the central defenders. They sometimes will go three at the back, and that allows the fullbacks to bomb forward like Mohaimin and Vestering. See that a lot from Zulfami. He likes those deep rolls, but then of course he has got very cultured passing as well. It's almost like a quarterback roll. Forward by Kong Ho Won, looking towards Stipe Plazibat. Well done, well handled by Madu Mahana. They kept the ball well. Forward by Jordan Vestering, and that goes out of play. And well, let's have a look at what happened here with Amir Zalani. The ball in from it was behind him, wasn't it? And I think he was trying to do something a little spectacular. And that amounts to the best opportunity or half chance that Hougang have had so far. Yasser has just gone down. Seems to be okay. Good to see. Now Joel Chu, again, that's too much on that ball for... Look at that, Irwan Shah. Running forward. He's the one who got the winner, as I mentioned. Good finish from Irwan as well. There, or sideways rather, from Nikesh Singh. Zulfami Arifin. Oh, Stipe on that left-hand side. Quickly whipped in by Vestering. Good control. Faris Rumley. Away by Dan Bennett. Vestering do well. This is good possession here from Hougang. Kong Ho Won. They get a free kick here. So Zufami to take this. They've got a few contenders. Kong Ho Won will be one. Afik another. And Stipe Plaziba. Those would be the three you'd really be aiming for, the big men. That's well dealt with by Madu Mahana. Here's Anu back to Zulfami. Looking for Kong Ho Won, who does get a little flick on it. Oh, maybe there was a little touch from Dan Bennett. It will be a corner. This is better now from Hougang. Could be a good moment here for Clementio. Lots of bodies around Shazwan. Referee will keep a close eye on this. Shazwan, he managed to get something on it. Looked like he had misjudged his jump. Zulfami running across to take the corner. There is the brains trust of Tampines Rovers, Gavin Lee and Kade Yaya, wanting their side to defend better than they have in recent weeks. Straight at the keeper from Zulfami. Shazwan just holding up the ball for the moment. And Joel Chu. Once again, he's gone down. Return ball from Irwan. Jordan Webb shown way too much of the ball there. Looked to be a foul by Webb on Kong Ho Won. He is looking a little bit frustrated. Did raise his arm, I think, on the Korean. Yeah, he tried to get past him. Showed a bit too much, but Kong Ho Won also went down pretty easily.
Plazibat dropping deeper and deeper at the moment. As we said, he has swapped with Faris Romli, the left and right. Nikesh there finds Plazibat. Now Vestering. Cut out by Jordan Webb. Amir Zalani, he's in a good position. Oh, best chance of the game so far. Amir Zalani hit that relatively well, but it was over the crossbar. Well, Mohaimin doing really well, cutting inside, laying the ball off to his striker, Amir. Well, not a bad effort at all. Faris can't quite believe that. Forward by Bennett. Nice take there by Yasser. He's not really got into the game so far, Yasser Hanapi. Is there a foul there? Oh, he didn't like that. Yasser reacts to the challenge from Anu. And really, in theory, that's got to be, at the bare minimum, a yellow card. There you go. I can't argue with that. He didn't like the challenge from Anu Manten. Let's have another look at this. Wasn't a great challenge, and I tell you what, that could have been a red card. And now he's really lucky here. By the letter of the law, if you lash out like that, you should be getting a red card. Maybe he's lucky it didn't really connect. But Yasser Hanapi, what's he thinking? So early on in this game, putting his team under tremendous pressure. Look what Stipe Plazibat is. How deep is he? Yasser. He's doing really well to hold on to the ball here, Yasser. And he's won a corner. Excellent work from him. He redeems himself after that yellow card. But to hold on to the ball like that, that was a nice bit of skill from him. And of course, all the players concerned about going in on him in case they fouled him and conceded a penalty. You could see here, he had two players on him, still managed to hold on the ball, then a third got involved, and then he got a corner. Oh, Jordan Webb didn't get quite the clean connection he wanted. He just ran into Yasser Hanapi, and that's their best chance so far. Away by Amirul. Well, the game has just picked up a little bit, hasn't it, in the last few minutes. Again, you've got two fine passes of the ball in Shadan Sulaiman for Tampines Rovers and Zulfami of Hougang. Both have had varying degrees of success. Happy to go back to Ridwan Barudin. Now Anu. Again, too far away from Faris. Well, it looked to be a clean challenge there from Afik on Yasser.
Now, has he got away with this? Well, he's got the ball. I have to say, it did look like he got the ball. Didn't think there was a foul in that. The referee didn't give a card. But it is heating up now, this game, nicely. We've got a slow start. The team's now just showing a little bit more. What a great ball from Bennett. That looked to be a foul on Shada, and the fouls are coming thick and fast. And now Anu, who went in on Yasser, now booked for the challenge on Shada. Yeah, was a little bit late. He did catch him. Don't think he really complained about that one. He's still not too happy about it. Nice work there, Megumi. Well, really good work by Vestering, who was just held on to that. Just fails to control it, Faris Romley. The other game, of course, going on at the moment, Jurong East between Geelong and Albrecht. That's 0-0. Now Zufami. Now Kong Ho Won. Shazwan picks it up. At the moment, the Tampines Rovers are just lacking that little bit of quality up front. You could argue they might need a Kyra Lumry in there. Oh, it's a good throw. Return Megumi. Where was everyone? No, Yasser. That's a tame attempt in the Emirates, Shadon Sulaiman. It's So Fambi trying to push his players further up.
That's a great ball out to Stipe Plazibat. Still Stipe. Corner for Hougang. Yes, Faris to take it. Away by Dan Bennett with Anu though. It will be a corner. Well, it looked like it got a little touch there. Eh? Piling up the set pieces here, Hougang. Zulfami whips it in. That's a straight header, totally unmarked. Kong Ho Won opens a scoring here. And where was the defending there for Tampines Rovers? He's not showing it, but he'll be absolutely delighted with that, Clement Teo. But Kong Ho Won makes it 1-0. Absolutely free header. Was that supposed to be Dan Bennett? I think he's looking at Jordan Webb. Well, that was not expected. I think a lot of people were thinking Tampines at home would make the difference. So need some to see something better here from Tampines. They've been pretty lackluster, haven't they, so far? Jordan Webb. Yeah, a bit more urgency would be good. Shadan. Megumi drop back a bit. Everyone shot tries to throw the ball up towards Jordan Webb. It's fallen nicely for him, but he was offside. Well, they want to keep up this intensity here, Hougang. Try and push a second. There's vulnerable Tampines Rovers at the moment. Oh, that would have been a great ball towards Madu. It was in a good position. Here's Stipe Plazibat. Dan Bennett gets in the way. Nothing wrong with that challenge. Here's Shadan. Zulfami first to the ball ahead of Yasser. Forrest trying to make a nuisance of himself. He does well. He's waiting for players to come and support. Nikesh. And now Muhaimin. Madu in the way. Here's Yasser. Back by Madu to Shazwan. Good ball out towards Jordan Webb. We need some of his excitement, his flair. We haven't seen enough of it in the last couple of games. Now Joel Chu. Shadan. Oh, good ball from Shadan. And that's well defended by Jordan Vestering. Delightful ball. Just a little bit too much on it. They'll have the corner. Oh, that was a good chance. He's put it over. Madu Mahana. He knows it. I think he wants to do better. Keep that down, obviously. He'll be disappointed with that. Anu. Vestering up to Stipe. Did well there, Vestering. Oh, nice from Afik. They're playing with confidence here, Hougang. A hesitation from the keeper. Onto the crossbar. The flag had gone up. Well, that looked a close one. And a good opportunity, but they're playing with confidence at the moment. I got to say, Tampines Rovers are looking a little bit vulnerable at the moment. Well, there's Jordan Webb. Done well. Oh, great return ball. Here's Webb. That's better from him. He's got a corner. Irwan Shah combining well with Jordan Webb. There's the Tampines Rovers fans. They've been hard at it. Not too much to cheer about at the moment. Vestering with the header. Megumi. Amrul Adli. There's Shadan trying to whip that in quickly. Again, Madu's left up there for some of the balls. Was that a handball by Afik? It was, of course, well outside the box with the elbow. Will be a free kick. It looks pretty much dead center. It's going to be Shadan Sulaiman. Here's Shadan. Sails over the crossbar. Not that far away, but it's one of their better opportunities. Just about 7 minutes or so till half time. Tampines Rovers trailing Hougang here. 1-0. Just wouldn't dip in time. And the goalkeeper had it covered, Ridwan Baradin. I think they need Carol Amri in today. Yeah, he'd be a happy man so far, Clementio. With Salim Moyne, the assistant coach, former Singapore international. The truth is that Tampines have not really stretched Hougang at the moment. Nicely done there by Shadan. You can see what Jordan was trying to do. Pick out Yasser. Still Jordan. Megumi. He's done well here, Megumi. Right across the box. Oh, they just needed some kind of contact on it. Irwan Shah didn't get the right kind. And that is such a good chance. Much better from Tampines Rovers. There is an injury at the moment. I think it's Nikesh, but look at this. Megumi did so well. And actually, that's been excellent defending. The Mohaimin is the one who's gone down. Brave defending. He got that right. That has prevented what looked to be a certain goal. Have another look at this. Great run from Megumi, right on the byline. Excellent intervention there from Muhaimin. Well, they can pull it back here before half time. We would have a very different second half. Well, Clementio is saying the ball needs to be returned back. And it seems that it reluctantly done so. But a thumbs up in the end from Clementio to Dan Bennett. I think there's certainly frustration at the moment being felt on this bench. Haven't had the cutting edge that we normally associate with Tampines Rovers. Mohaimin is back on the pitch. Back by Afik. Shazwan did well there. Shah Shahiran falling over. No damage. Nicely done by Shadan. Well, I thought Megumi might try to take a shot earlier. He's still going, but in the end, it's cleared away by Vestering. Joel Chu, that's got to be a handball. Not spotted by the referee. A yank bank by Yasser as well. It has certainly got a little feisty, hasn't it, as the match has progressed. Oh, poor clearance by Ridwan. Here's Shadan Sulaiman. He's got Jordan Webb, who can bear down on goal. Jordan Webb! Not a great shot. Decent save by Ridwan, but it's one you'd expect him to make. The shot far too close to him. It's a late flurry here from Tampines Rovers. And that represents a much better opportunity as well. There are a couple of players here. Yasser, no flag. Oh, and it's straight at the keeper from Shadan Sulaiman. And all of a sudden, Tampines Rovers have picked up a head of steam, but their efforts have not found the back of the net. So here is that opportunity. Yasser then squaring the ball, doing really well to find Shadan. Shadan any other side of the goal, and it surely would have been in. And just before that, of course, was Jordan Webb's opportunity. Well, now I think it might be Hougang. I'm thinking it could be a good time for that halftime whistle. Jordan Westering taking his time, to the annoyance of the Tampines bench and players. Anu and Westering combining well. Taking another deflection. Here's Anu. They want to just see this out now. We're into added time. We're just going to have the 1 minute here. They can see this out. Hougang will be pretty pleased with this, though. Perhaps Tampines wouldn't mind the first half going a little bit longer. They've just started to build a little bit of momentum. Halftime perhaps coming at the wrong moment for them. That's nicely shepherded by Dan Bennett. Is there time for one more opportunity this half for Tampines Rovers? Here's Madu Mahana. Now Shah Shahiran, offside. Oh no, it's a foul on Shah by his opposite number, Jordan Westering. And now it'll just give them the opportunity to pile some bodies forward here. This will surely be the last chance of the first half. Floated in the far post, it's taking a deflection there. Jordan Webb's header. Well, they've got the corner. They're playing well beyond the 1 minute, I can tell you that. It's about a minute and a half now. And that is put over the top by Jordan Webb, and it brings to an end this first half. A half in which Hougang had worked very hard. The game did take a while to get going, but Hougang struck first. And it was a header, a free header from Kong Ho Won. Poor defending from Tampines in that instance. Tampines still did not respond for quite some time. And towards the end of the first half, a few chances for them. But they can't get past Ridwan Baruddin. He has made a couple of saves, but nothing spectacular. Tampines have a lot of work to do in the second half. Halftime score here at our Tampines Hub. Tampines Rovers 0, Hougang United 1.
And I think they've reacted to that by bringing on one of their foreign players, the Serbian Zeradin Mehmedovic. He's replaced Joel Chu in that midfield area. But still no change. Oh, Hafiz Sujad is also coming on. So Jordan Vestering is also off. That's with Hougang, of course. And so they're bringing on the Singapore international, Hafiz Sujad, to replace Vestering. So it'll be a little bit of a change there. Hafiz, of course, plays left back. He likes to go forward, though. There he is now. Wonder when will we see Kairu Lamri to give them that cutting edge up front. Experiment so far with Yasser Hanapi is not really working. Onside there, Vazeruddin, here's Yasser. Back to Webb. Now, Shah Shahiran. Flick on there from Madu Mohana, Ritaro Megumi. Had some good runs. Back to Yasser. Irwan Shah. Quicker passing. Mehmedovic keeps it ticking away. That's what he does. Nicely done by Mehmedovic. They can get the cross in from Irwan Shah. Disguised that fairly well. Pressure from the start. Here is Yasser. Was there a foul on him by Kong Ho Won? Yasser is still on the floor. This is a bit better intensity from Tampines. Oh, lovely ball from Shadan up towards Megumi, but Ridwan had that covered. They just need to relieve that pressure a little bit at the moment, this Hougang side. Now Anu. They are pressing just a little bit more now, Tampines. Faris. That's a good challenge by Amirul Adli. Amir Zalani had a good chance in that first half. Here's Anu. They want to spell a possession now, Hougang. Faris. Oh, he just bundled over there by Irwan Shah. No foul. Well, the bemused look on Faris's face earlier. Clamatio shouting a bit more passion from the manager. He's going to go for a slightly longer throw here, Mohamed. Ops for a short one in the end. Mehmedovic. Nicely done by him. That looked like a bit of a foul by Anu. I don't know what Yasser's doing. He thinks it was a Tampines free kick over there. Does appear as if Tampines just look a little tired, a little jaded after that, the exertions of the AFC Cup on Wednesday. It does set things up beautifully for a final day encounter with Hanoi, who started the tournament very well. They've faded a little bit, but should Tampines get a draw, they will finish as group winners. And they're at the moment very likely to go through anyway as the best placed second team or runners up. Well, there's no doubt about the foul there by Yasser Hanapi, and he might get a card here. He's been riding a fine line today, and he's kind of frustrated figure, and we know what that means. Well, he has to go, Yasser Hanapi. He already got a yellow in the first half, remember. Why was he doing that? He knew he was on a yellow. He's been yanking back. Why on earth would he do it? He can't put his hands up and say, I didn't do anything. And that, I'm afraid, is really not going to help the team here, who are already a goal and now a man down. Now, how does Gavin Lee rearrange things? Well, maybe it's an opportune time to bring on Kyra Lamry in a while, but of course they've just got to think about how they want to shuffle the pack. But they have got an uphill task here, Tampines Rovers. But what was Yasser Hanapi thinking there? He's put his team under tremendous pressure now when they're already a goal down. And to be fair, he didn't show too much dissent. I think he knew exactly what was going to happen. And tell you what, Hougang will be very happy with this now. Well, this game started very innocuously and it has become quite feisty. So Gavin, now what will he do? He has Kyra Lamry available. I think he just wants to hold on to him as long as possible if he can. Here's Mehmedovic surging forward, looking up. Webb can't get past Faris Rumley. Now, I think he's just been mouthing off to the referee a little bit. He's not going towards the referee as well. He's got to be careful how he's dealing with Aman Akasha. And they got some serious problems here, Tampines Rovers. And now Dan Bennett. They will stick with things the way they are. And just looking at the way they are forming up now, it looks like Mehmedovic is the forwardmost player.
They are playing 4-2-3 now with Shah Shahiran and Shahdan Sulaiman is on the ball now with, you'd assume, Mehmedovic just dropping from time to time to help out. Ball out towards Jordan Webb. Kong Ho Won in the way. Can they take advantage here? Nikesh Singh playing quite a good ball out to Faris Ramli. Little bit stretched at the moment, Tampines. He's done well. Faris, you're going to go for goal. That is a brilliant strike. Fantastic goal. Started out from the back. Nikesh Singh spotting him with that wonderful crossfield ball. And he had a lot of work to do there, Faris Ramli. And he scored it brilliantly. Little step over here past Irwan Shah. Did so well there, and he placed it beautifully. What a goal that is. And Hougang are now in pole position here, 2-0 up, and with a one-man advantage. Well, what are they going to do? Surely now they've got to look at bolstering their attack. There's serious trouble here. Can they pull one back? Almost immediately they do. Shah Shahiran. Well, well. Is there still life in this game? Well, they are always saying you're the most vulnerable just after you've scored. And that seems to be the case here. It didn't look like there was anything on here. Nice ball slipped through by Megumi, and a great finish as well by Shah. And it's timely to see Khairul Amri coming on now. And I just wonder who they were going to take off. Were they going to take off Shah at that point? It would make the most sense in terms of personnel on the pitch. That is rather cruel, though. It is going to be Shah. Wow. That's the just reward for you getting a goal. If you get taken off, you've got to feel sorry for him a little bit. Gavin Lee is being clinical and ruthless about things. You can understand where he's coming from. What a player to be able to bring on. Khairul Amri, 7 goals already this season, including a hat-trick in the last game against Yangon United. He had plenty of chances in that game, by the way, including one absolute open goal. But he has a chance to redeem himself here. I tell you what, now maybe the momentum has just shifted a little bit. It just sprung them into life, hasn't it? Tampines Rovers. So literally, that was the last thing he did, Shah Shahiran, by scoring the goal. Cheeky effort there by Jordan Webb. They're not shirking away from attacking, Tampines Rovers, to their credit. And they'll need another goal to just kill it off here, Hougang. Mehmedovic. Has he managed to keep that in? No, it's just gone out for Madu. Now Mehmedovic will just have to drop a little into that midfield role with Shahdan. You'll also need Megumi and Webb to help out from time to time. 4-4-1 really should be what it is now, just to make sure that midfield isn't overrun.
Well, this is turning out to be a pretty good game now. Mehmedovic. Oh, he's made a mistake here. Can Abezalani finish it? What a chance he has spurned. And Shazwan Bukhari keeps Tampines in the game here, but it was a poor mistake at the back there that allowed Amir Zalani in, and that had to be finished off. And could that come back to haunt them? Kong Hwan stayed strong. He's still going forward, chasing back here to Shazwan, closing down. They're trying to take advantage of that hole. It's a good ball, Jordan Webb. Oh, and an important touch on. Really important touch on by Muhaimin. This game is really opening up now. Well, there was Shadan's mistake. Amir Zalani just snatching at that. And that was a glorious opportunity. Away by Afik. Still alive here. It'll be a corner. Well, they seem to be more effective with 10 men than they were with 11. Tampines Rovers. It's a credit to them that they have kept it. Kept up the intensity. Plaziba thought about letting Ridwan come to the ball. He's under pressure from Jordan Webb. Well, no one then getting to the ball. You could hear some shouting there. By the way, Faris Ramli is the outright second highest goal scorer with 7 goals after scoring earlier. What a great goal that was, wasn't it? Excellent from him. Talking of goals, there is another game going on at the moment. Albrecht Nagata are playing Geylang International at the Jurong East Stadium. That kicked off at the same time, despite some issues with the team bus earlier. And it is still goalless over there. Albrecht, of course, are in third place after a very underwhelming start to the season. Here is Faris off the crossbar. And that's excellent from him. And a little unlucky. Well, he's hunting for more goals. Just cut inside there with Madu. Did really well. And he is a massive threat at the moment. Good one-touch football there. Here's Kong Hwan. Oh, lovely. Now Muhaimin, good ball! What a finish again! What a ball! Ball across Faris Ramli, and he puts that in, and they've restored their 2-goal advantage. After just hitting the crossbar earlier, it's now 3-1, and great work from Muhaimin with 2 assists in this match. Great ball in from him. And Faris now with 8 goals. Well, just when Tampines were looking to get themselves back in this, they concede and they now can bring on Singapore international. Amir Zalani has done his part today. He's played well. And they've got a very experienced forward line now. Not bad player to bring on, Fazul Nawaz. Normally comes on in the second half. But they've got a lot of work to do here. Tampines Rovers, foul on Jordan Webb. Well, this puts a serious dent in Tampines Rovers' title ambitions if they cannot get something out of this game. Here's Fazrul. They're going to get stretched here as well as they go searching for goals. And who better to stretch you? Oh, it's just behind Stipe Plazibar, but that ball from Faris Rumley. Well, they've made a couple of changes already, Tampines Rovers. They've got one more card to play. You just wonder who they might use. Here's Jordan Webb. Well, they could use Zulfadmi Suzliman, who, or Tofik Suparno. That would be the two obvious ones. Here's Ritar Megumi. Can he pull another one back here? Surely, Mehmedovic! Oh, great finish! Right to that bottom corner. This game has been turned on its head once again. And every time Hougang score, Tampines bounce back. And every time we write them off, they just show they are here to stay for a little longer in this game. Great work again from Megumi. Pulling it back. And he finished it perfectly right into that corner. Well, this is turning into quite the game, I have to say, here at our Tampines hub. And there's still a good almost half an hour left, if you include some added time. Not showing too much emotion. There's a lot of work still to be done here for 10-man Tampines. But once again, Hougang will have to score just to make things more comfortable. Anu towards Fazrul. The two international teammates there tussling. Well, as I said, they've still got firepower in Taufik and Zulfadmi. Zulfadmi, who can run at players and cause all kinds of problems. The question is, who are you going to take off? They presumably want to keep on Megumi and Webb. Would you then start to having take risks? Would you maybe take off an Irwan Shah or Madu Mohana and let Zulfadmi play an attacking fullback role? And he's asking, why are you not giving me advantage here, Mehmedovic? He's annoyed with that. It's a booking for Nikesh Singh. Yeah, that's the point he's making. Got to play advantage, ref. That's what Mehmedovic is telling Ahmad Akasha. Well, that looks like a great challenge from Afik, and I don't think Amri was too happy with that. Now Faris. Well, they'll play on here. Now Stipe Plazibat! Oh, it's come off the post! He'd beaten the goalkeeper, but not the woodwork. Oh, this game has really, really got so much better. And up the other end now, Jordan Webb. He's going on his own. Oh, Karen Emery! Brilliant! We're all square here at our Tampines hub. Excellent work from Jordan Webb. And now a little bit more emotion from the Tampines bench. Oh, it is 3-3. Well, this has twisted and turned just like Jordan Webb did here. Excellent. We haven't seen enough of those runs to the byline. And who was on Khairul Amri? Into an empty net. And it is game on, ladies and gentlemen. And I tell you what, Hougang must be thinking, how we not wrap this game up and now we are under pressure. Well, if you're in the neighborhood, do come down for the last 25 minutes or so to our Tampines hub. It is all happening here. I tell you what, the way it is going, you feel there are still more goals in this. And wouldn't it be a story if it is Tampines that could somehow go on to win this? Zulfami Arifin. Well, there's been some generous defending on both sides, which will be of massive frustration to the coaches. Don't forget, we'll be hearing from them after the match, so do stay with us for those interviews. And Jordan Webb, the flag has stayed down. Will he do the same kind of thing? This time it takes a little bit of a deflection off Muhaimin. You see a substitution happen shortly. Fabian Kwok is going to come on for Hougang. Just to try and consolidate things. I would have thought Hougang would try to attack more. And the ball has been put out of play because Mehmedovic is down. So Nikesh Singh is going off. He's going to be replaced by Fabian Kwok. The experienced Fabian Kwok. Now, where is he going to go? Into the centre of midfield? Or straight swap with Nikesh Singh? Well, they brought on Fazlul Nawaz for a bit more experience and firepower. Now, I think Fabian Kwok, he might be going into defence here. He has done that before, and they might be playing a three-man defence now with Hafiz Sujad pushing further up on one side, Muhaimin on the other. It is going to be a three-man defence. He did that. He has done that previously. So it looks like it's a 3-4-3 now for Hougang. So they're just going to give their fullbacks a little bit more licence, and someone like Hafiz Sujad, I think, will prefer that as well. Here he is now. This could go either way. Really could. And you've got to give a lot of credit to Tampines Rovers. Away by Madu. Only gets it as far as Anu. Now Zulfami. Fazrul back to Fabian. His first touch of the ball. Interesting that it's not Zulfami who's gone into the back into defence, and rather it's Fabian. But I think the thinking is that Zulfami can still pull the strings in midfield. Dan Bennett gets it at header first. Well, in theory, you'd think Tampines would be happier with the point, given that they're down to 10 men, but they know this is a great opportunity to catch up because they've got games in hand. So they don't really want to sit back either. Irwan Shah with the header. Here's Muhaimin. Mohamed Muhana does well. Now Fazrul. Muhaimin forces a corner. This game has really, really come to life, hasn't it, in the last 20 minutes. Not long after the first half of the second half started. Away for now. Muhaimin just hesitated. Here's Kyra Lumry to lead the counter. Jordan Webb, he needed a better ball to set Jordan free. Fazrul, that's good work from Madu.
Yeah, just get the impression neither team is willing to settle for points here, which is great for us, of course, watching this. Shannon Sulaiman. Dan Bennett launching that out towards Jordan Webb. It's gone out of play. He's not happy with the ball that he got. Let's remind you again, there are two matches this evening. Here is Jordan Webb. Still goalless, by the way, at the Jurong East Stadium between Albrecht and Geelong. Tell you what, you would not know at the moment that Tampines are down to 10 men. Let's be generous and call that a shot on target, shall we? Ridwan was pretty comfortable with that. If it stays the way it is, of course, the biggest winners of this will be DPMM. And Albrecht will be relatively happy as well. Yeah, it'll be interesting to know whether what the strategy is as far as Tampines. What are they thinking? Were they still looking to get all 3 points in this game? Certainly appears to be the case. And that is a credit to the team. They are plugging away. They're working hard here. Here's Ritaro Megumi. Spots Mehmedovic. No foul. Ball in from Irwan Shah. Had to be better. Now Zulfami. Hyman's had a fine game. Here he is. Quick pass on from Fazrul. Oh, he's done well there, Faris Ramli. Really well. Foul definitely by Irwan Shah. He's found it difficult up against Faris today. And he will get a free kick. A good area. Gone near post, away by Megumi. Now Muhaimin. Anu. Happy to go all the way back to Kong Ho Won, or rather Fabian Kwok. Now Fazrul. Stipe Plasba, I haven't seen much of him actually in a while. Apart from that shot that hit the post not too long ago. Fast approaching the final 10 of this game. And it's still 3-3 between Tampines Rovers and Hougang United. Hafiz Sujad here with the throw. Finds Plazibat. Anu Mantan to Zulfami Arifin. There's a little run there from Hafiz, not taking that option. Kong Ho Won. Mohaimin. It's good defensive work from Jordan Webb. Those two tussling. That's a definite foul by Mohaimin. That could be a yellow card if he's not careful. Just getting a little talking to from Ahmad Akasha. Now Megumi. Shadan. Are they willing to just share a point here? Are they going to start leaving themselves a bit exposed? Or they go for it? Coming forward here, Shadan. Now Jordan Webb. Faris coming back to help. Mehmedovic. He's certainly made a difference since his introduction. At the break. It's patient play for the moment from Tampines Rovers. Shadan. Nice turn on there from Megumi. Nicely won back by Manu Mohana. Now Kyle Emery on in that right hand side. Amri just thought about shooting. Now Mehmedovic. Nice ball play through. Jordan Webb, it wouldn't sit for him. Zofami. Spreading that wide. Here's Stipe Plazibat. Well, had he put his chance away, it could be a different story now. Anumantan. Headed by Mehmedovic. Here's Fazrul Nawaz. Anu, now Zofami. Faris done well. Plazibat surely is wrestled to the ground by Kongho Won. It's got to be a yellow card. By Amirul Adli. Excuse me. Wrong number five. Yeah, no doubt about that one. It was pretty high, in fact, the hand. Now, Zofami, this is his kind of territory. Surely now, if he scores this, that would be it. Well, we know what Zofami Arafin can do. I want to just be wary of that. And Shazwan as well. Well, it's right into the wall. That's not a great free kick from him. Here's Webb.
Now Megumi.
He's done well here, Webb. Gets the ball back to Megumi. Can he get the cross in? It's behind Karol Amri. Mehmedovic.
Now Shadan, he's someone who can unlock this stubborn Hougang defence. Oh, it's very, very good challenge by Muhaimin.
Now, great ball from Zulfami. Just spotted a run of Stipe Plazibat.
Fazrul.
Oh, that's a great move, and it's just over from Faris Ramli. He heads that over the crossbar.
That's another great chance.
Wow, this is interesting. Jordan Webb is being taken off. And Taufik Suparno will get a little cameo.
So they might play with two strikers here. Nice to see the intent from Tampines. They are not just trying to play for that point. Here he is, Taufik. Interesting, they've gone for him and taken Webb off. Megumi too close to the keeper, of course.
We can tell you there has just been a goal at the Jurong East Stadium, and it's Kyoga Nakamura there, very canny, number 10. Is there a penalty shout there? None whatsoever. The shot is blocked. There's also a red card, by the way. Noor Arif brought down Daiso Horikoshi, got his second yellow. So both games with teams down to 10, but Nakamura has just scored for Albrecht Niigata. That also has implications for this game. If Albrecht go on to finish it off, they will be on 17 points. In fact, they'll be the big winners here today, along with DPMM. Frustration that the ball didn't go all the way through. Faris, charged down by Dan Bennett. We are just about to enter the 90th minute of play. Taufik will not get there, and Ridwan alerts. And as I said, the draw will not really do either team too much good. So will we get a last gasp winner? Albrecht have just doubled their tally. Incredible. Nakamura has just scored a second. And it's all crumbling very late on for Geelang. Goal kick. Now we're waiting to hear from the referee as to how many minutes he's going to add on. I think maybe Tampines might now be content for that 1 point. Just 3 minutes they're playing.
I think it's Hougang who will be pushing now like mad to try and get that win if they can. Anu. Now Afik. Kong Ho Won, ball in. Dan Bennett deals with it well. Is it going to be Mehmedovic? Oh, he couldn't get his slide in. Faris Ramli. He scored from this sort of pace before. Was there a penalty? No. He goes down. He's furious with that. Oh, and I think he might have some valid claims. He thinks he was fouled. Well, well. Was there a claim there? Amirul Adli, I think, was a player. He got past. Going forward up the other way, Retaro Megumi. It's a good ball, but just too much on it. And they won't be able to get on the end of that. And we've got about a minute or so to go. Here's Kong Ho Won. The Korean up towards Plazibat. Now Megumi. I think they'll just try to keep the ball now. Clamatio, I think we'll look at this as two points dropped. They'd be really, really disappointed by that. Mohamed says he has a bit of a problem here. They've already made their changes. They're going to have to play with 10, I think. It's only a short time to do that. They need to get the ball up the other side. The referee decides he has had enough. And what a game we had here at our Tampines Hub. Hougang looked to be running away with this match. They were 1-0 up at halftime. Thanks to Kong Ho Won's header. Then Yasser Hanapi, I don't know what he was thinking, but he got sent off. It then became two through Faris Ramli. But then the fight back began for Tampines Rovers. They made it 2-2 after goals from Kairul Amri. Zeruddin Mehmedovic as well, and Shah Shahiran. After Tampines Rovers had scored a third through Faris. And so that brings to an end what has been a very good game in the second half especially. And it must be frustration for them because they would have narrowed the gap with DPMM. And it's now, incredibly, Albirex who go into second after beating Geylang 2-0 right at the end of that match. Final score here at our Tampines Hub in this AIA Singapore Premier League match. It's Tampines Rovers 3, Hougang United 3.
That's a wrap for this episode of One Play Classic. Do remember to stay tuned to One Play Sports as we continue our effort to create heroes and connect communities. Remember to follow us on our social media channels, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram and Twitter for the latest updates. We'll see you next time.